Mike, producer Mike, has just escorted WBAL TV meteorologist Ava Marie into the studio.
She needs an escort?
Yeah, Mike. Yeah. Okay, she's an adult. She doesn't need an escort.
Yes, Mike. She recently, I believe, had her hair lightened.
Now, Mike, would you like to...
Why is she in here?
Yeah, Mike, would you like to set this up, please?
Well, it's going to be really hot this week. Is it going to be the hottest week so far this summer, Ava?
Yes. Yeah, both
get
the
real close
temperatures,
on that.
Both the temperatures and the humidity make it the combination hottest of the summer so far. But it's July.
To survive.
That, right?
So yesterday in our meeting, we said, hey, this might be the week that we do our annual hot car PSA, where we put one of the show members outside in their vehicle facing the sun. And
just to show what kind of sissies dogs and babies are. actually do a PSA to say, hey, don't leave children, babies, elderly, or fresh tubs of ice cream in a hot car.
Or pets.
Pets.
You know, what's funny, though, actually.
Those two.
We always think of it when it's this hot. It's pretty obvious not to leave someone in a car at this temperature. But it can get really hot even on a 70-degree day. So hopefully this is a good awareness for everyone. But I want you to remember just how quickly a car can heat up inside even when the outside temperature is really comfortable. So even on a typical 70-degree day, it could get dangerously hot inside a car.
I think that we should drug Keith Mills, put one of those bags on his head. Like they do with Guantanamo.
Is this one of your fantasies, Josh?
Yes, it is.
What are we walking into here?
And then tie him up and have him in the car. He's a major figure in this town. Imagine the publicity, the good he can do.
I'm just gonna start by saying I don't condone any of this, but I'm here to help, maybe with the science of it.
All right.
So I guess we're trying to figure out when is the best. What's going to be the hottest night into day. We were thinking Wednesday night into Thursday morning, going and putting somebody out and putting me out there.
You have to do it in the morning because you guys are
obviously here.
You want to do it on air. Let's see.
We'll put them on when we leave and when Kirk and Marianne take over.
I'd say Thursday is probably going to be the hottest.
Thursday morning, right. Yeah, that's what we were thinking.
Yeah, because that's the last day of the extreme heat. It's going to be the most humid as well. So the afternoon should be in the mid-90s, but even the morning will be quickly starting out in the upper 70s.
What was that graphic you guys are using that... tracks the heat and the humidity? It's
the heat index.
No, but I think maybe Miri came up with the graphic or you came up with it, and it kind of says like uncomfortable or sticky or muggy.
Oh, yeah, my humidity, yeah.
Yes,
miserable.
I love that. Miserable.
Oh, good, yeah. Because
it puts it in terms that we all can, you know.
Is
like,
it called the misery meter?
Watch out, misery meter.
Watch out now.
I need to use Josh as a consultant because
I would love to
my
be a
graphics
consultant.
Are boring.
Guys, let's check the meter.
Just added some
it was a great graphic.
You can have
misery
that if you want.
Misery meter. I like it. Yeah, you know what's funny, though? That's all kind of subjective, but I think everyone can pretty much agree that unless you're in the pool, a heat index of 100 is pretty miserable.
So that's where we're at today, tomorrow, and Thursday.
Thursday's probably the hottest day. Heat index could be in the low 100s. When it starts to inch towards 105, that gets in the dangerous zone that people can start to easily have heat stroke.
So the danger zone, you say?
If we're up in the 90s, what kind of humidity, what percentage does it start to be like, ugh?
So I like to think about 60. Dew points because I don't want to bore you guys all too much listening, but the problem is the humidity, the percentage you see changes throughout the day, whereas the dew point stays the same. So that's a better indication. So anytime the dew point is basically above 65, we start to feel humid. Right now the dew point is near 70.
Whoa!
And I'm really glad I bought a new car with all leather seats so my back peels off of it like that same plastic
that
on a cheese slice.
Leather seats, huh?
It ain't good.
Leather seats?
I'm making that leather seat kind of money.
Damn,
I believe
son.
It's a leather blend. So the first year who went in the car, was it Mike or Josh?
It was Spiegel.
Then you.
Year one. Then me. Then you.
Last year, the only thing they gave me to refresh myself, Ava Marie, was an ice cold jar of blue cheese. We're thinking on Thursday we give Scott a big old piping hot bowl of chili and some hot chocolate. The only thing he can like hydrate himself with.
Would that help though? Because it would help you sweat, and doesn't that cool your body?
Yeah, but if it's that humid. It just sits on your skin. That's why it feels worse when it's hot and humid. You always talk about the dry heat in Arizona. Well, when it is a dry heat, you do sweat. It evaporates. That cools you down. Otherwise, when your skin is just wet and it's hot, it just makes you feel worse.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
So is it a bad day to like be doing outside activity?
The earlier, the better. You know, right now, basically, you need to add about 5 degrees to the temperature for how hot it's going to feel. So if it's 95 this afternoon, it feels like 100. So it's all about your comfort level. But you're definitely going to find yourself tiring out quicker in this kind of heat.
And if you'd like to have a comfortable summer yourself, Josh, his headphones are off. He can't hear this. Do not take the misery meter idea.
No, you could take the misery meter.
Damn it, his headphones are still on.
I would actually be so flattered if he used it. But
could you use his face in the graphic? Like, the hotter it is, the more he starts to frown and scowl.
No, you don't have to do that.
You have to do it.
We should combine partnership and think of something like
synergy.
That.
Synergy.
Yeah. Is that something you can just implement yourself, or do you need to run that by somebody?
For social media, I can basically do whatever I want. For the on-air work, I've got some boundaries.
The Josh Spiegel branded misery meter.
Yeah.
Let's
work on this. I like that. Okay. This could be a good partnership for at least social media.
Nice. Yes. I have lots of ideas.
I want it for broadcast.
There's charts online. I'll make sure you guys find this, but basically it shows just how quickly a car will heat up based off of a certain amount of time. So basically it can heat up about 45 degrees just in an hour.
Well, we're going to find out Thursday morning.
Mm-hmm. So I hope you have like a little, thermometer that you'll track.
Oh, we do. We put one on the outside. We put one on the inside. We're very high tech around here.
So I guess I'm going to, just based on this, I would guess if it's, going to be in the 80s when you're out there that morning, it's going to be about 120 in the car.
Whoa! What?
I have an idea.
I have an idea for this, but I can't bring it up until you're gone. So
get out.
Thank you for stopping by. It's a decency thing. If Dan Jarrus finds out that I said this in your presence, he's going to take a wiffle ball bat to my head.
I appreciate it. And I want to see this. When are you guys going to do it? I can't
Thursday.
Wait.
Thursday morning. 8 o'clock hour.
Actually, can I go out on a limb here?
Josh.
How about bringing a camera out? Getting
Yes. I can work on that. I can pull some strings, try to get you guys a camera out for that.
I bet Josh doesn't get any pushback this time.
that'll be great.
As it's all done safely, we can be on board. And it is a great message.
Idea that I have, we won't film that, but everything around it. It's a great idea. It's great PSA. It's helpful this time of year. Your compatriots downstairs wish they didn't have to, but they do the stories every year where someone leaves someone in a car, whether it be a baby, a toddler, a dog, a cat, an elderly person, like Keith Mills. We hope you don't have to, but you maybe will. And if we can do this and inform someone, we will.
Yeah. Get the message out, too, that teach your kids never to just play and crawl in a car, because we hear stories that are really sad when a child accidentally goes in a car by itself and gets locked in. Parents don't even know where they are.
Right. Kids are dumb.
Should I send an email to Tim or do you have that pitch?
Let me approach it first. How about
okay,
that?
All right.
And then I'll get you guys on board. But just, no, this is cool story. Just
great. That's the second great idea I brought today. Misery meter and coverage of Scott.
Okay, I'm looking forward to it, guys.
Thank you so much. There she is, Ava Marie, WBAL, TV 11 News, keeping you up to speed with all the weather news that you could use. And now that she's gone, Scott, we're going to put a meat thermometer between your butt cheeks. We're going to have you clench one.
Done.
We're going to have that. Yeah, we're going to right in the crack of your ass. That same thing that I used to stick into a pot roast to make sure that's done. We'll have one for the air temperature.
We'll have one outside temperature, one inside temperature of the car, and then one inside of my butt.
Yeah, we're going to have a butt crack meter.